let us know what are polar curves. So now let us consider a point P in the xy plane. The x-axis is called as the initial line. The point, the origin O is called as the pole. Then join OP. This OP is called as the radius vector. And the angle between the radius vector and the initial line is nothing but theta. So this theta is also called as the radial angle. Now the ordered pair r comma theta, which are the coordinates of point P, are called as the polar coordinates. Now from the drop a perpendicular from the point P onto the initial line Q. So PQ is the perpendicular onto the initial line. So from the right angle triangle OPQ, cos theta is equal to x by r. So from that we get x is equal to r cos theta. Sin theta is equal to y by r, which is equal to r sin. So this implies that y is equal to r sin theta. Squaring and adding x and y, we get x square plus y square equal to r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta, which is equal to r square. So from this we get r is equal to root of x square plus y square. Then y by x will give you r sin theta by r cos theta, which is equal to tan theta. So from this theta is equal to tan inverse of y by x. So this is the relationship between the polar coordinates and the Cartesian coordinates x comma y. So the point P can be represented by the polar coordinates r comma theta or the Cartesian coordinates x comma y. Now if this point P moves or varies, then it traces a curve which is called as the polar curve. Then r is equal to f of theta is called the polar curve, that is, it is the equation of the polar curve.